Hello everyone, now I'm going to start question number 2 of exercise 1.1. In this question we have, write the additive inverse of each of the following. Now additive inverse, as you know, that the whatever number is given, we will just change the sign. Here in front of this plus sign is given, that means if we change the sign, it will be minus. So the additive inverse of 2 by 8 is minus 2 by 8. Now we will just check if we add these two, whether we are getting 0 or not. See, if we add these two, plus minus 0. So that means this is the additive inverse of this. Here, the additive inverse of minus 5 by 9. So these things you don't have to show. This I have just shown you so that you can understand the how to understand that one number is the additive inverse of another number. If we add this two and if we get zero, then we can say that one number is additive inverse of another number. Now, in the next one, we have minus 5 by 9. So the additive inverse of minus 5 by 9 is 5 by 9. Here also, see, this was the number minus 5 by 9 and the additive inverse of this is 5 by 9 and see opposite sign but the same number, so we can cancel it and we are getting 0. That means this is the additive inverse of this. Now in this sum, minus 6 divided by minus 5, here both the sign is negative, so we can cancel it. First we will have to solve this one and then we will write the additive inverse of that. So here, since minus sign is given and here also this minus sign is given, so minus minus plus, so it will be 6 by 5. Now we will find the additive inverse of 6 by 5. So the additive inverse of 6 by 5 is minus 6 by 5. Now in the next we have 2 by minus 9. Now here, we can make it positive because 2 by minus 9 or minus 2 by 9 is same only. So at first I am writing minus 2 by 9. So the additive inverse of minus 2 by 9 is 2 by 9. It will be just opposite of this since it is having negative sign, so it will be positive. Now here also, 19 by minus 6 means minus 19 by 6. So the additive inverse of minus 19 by 6 is 19 by 6. So minus will be positive. So in case of additive inverse, sign changes. Plus will be minus and minus will be plus. Now in the next question we have, verify that minus minus x is equals to x. Here 2 minus sign is given, so 2 minus will be positive and we will get the same number, that we will have to show it. So here x is equals to 11 by 15. So at first this is, see, before equal sign this is called left hand side and this is the right hand side. So we will have to take left hand side at first. And on the left hand side, see, minus minus x is given. So we will write minus the same thing which is given in the question. Now here this minus is this, again here is minus sign, so we'll put minus sign. After that, here see x is given. Now x means the value of x is given in the question, which is 11 by 15. Now we know that 2 minus makes positive because minus minus positive, so we are getting 11 by 15. And see here, 11 by 15 means x, so again we are getting the same things from where we have started. So that means is equals to x, and see on the right hand side, x is there. So left hand side is equals to right hand side because from here we have started and we have got the same thing which is given on the right hand side. So left hand side is equals to right hand side, verified, because we have to verify it. Now in the next sum we have x is equals to minus 13 by 17. Now according to the question, minus minus x is given. So again we will write left hand side. Now here left hand side is minus minus x. Now this minus sign is this. again, here minus sign is given. This minus sign is this. This minus sign is this. Now we have x. Now value of x is minus 13 by 17. So we will write minus 13 by 17. This means x. Okay. Now 2 minus makes positive, and this minus 13 by 17. Now plus minus minus. So minus 13 by 17. And minus 13 by 17 means x, which is given in the question. So this equals to x. So we can write that left hand side is equals to right hand side. Verified. So this was question number 3. Thank you, students.